to all. I'm going to recite a poem, The Spider and the Fly by Mary Howitt. "Oh, will you walk into my parlor?" said the spider to the fly. "'Tis the prettiest little parlor that ever you did spy. The way into my parlor is up a winding stairs, and there are many curious things to show when you're there." "Oh, no," said the little fly, "'twas amazing why, for who goes up your winding stairs can never come down again. But I'm sure you must be very dear, and soaring up so high. Will you rest upon my little bed?" said the spider to the fly. "There are pretty cushions down around, the sheets are fine and thin, and if you like to rest a while, I will snugly tuck you in." "Oh, no, no," said the little fly, "for I've often heard it said, the never wake again will sleep upon your bed." Said the cunning spider to the fly, "My dear friend, what can I do to prove the warm affection I've always felt for you? I have within my pantry good store of all that's nice. Will you please to take a slice?" "Oh, no, no," said the little fly. "Kind as I cannot be, I've heard what's in your pantry I do not wish to see." "Sweet creature," said the spider, "you're witty and you're wise. How handsome are your gauzy wings. How brilliant are your eyes. I have a little looking glass upon my parlor shelf. If you step in one moment, dear, you shall behold yourself." "Well, thank you, gentle sir," she said, "for what you're pleased to say, and bidding you a good morning now and call another day." The spider turned him round about and went to his den. For well he knew the silly little fly would soon back again. So he wore a subtle web in a little corner sly, and set his table ready to dine upon the fly. Then he came out to his den again, and merrily did sing, "Come hither, hither, pretty fly, with the pearl and silver wing. Your robes are green and purple, there's a crest upon your head. Your eyes are like the diamond bright, but mine are dull as lead." "Alas, alas, how very soon the silly little fly," here his wild fluttering verse came slowly flitting by. With buzzing wings she hung aloft, then nearer and nearer drew.